I've been given the very interesting task to sum up a session that I didn't attend. But given the fact that this is a session about education, and I'm also the head of the School of Land and Food, I thought it was probably appropriate that I take on that challenge. I did talk to some of the people who did attend, and I've got some really good notes on it. Apparently the discussion focused, or began, in fact, with looking at how we can change the image of agriculture to something that is much more positive, promotes the employment opportunity and the jobs, and particularly targets the teachers and the parents in order to get a much better understanding of what tertiary education in agriculture actually means. It's not muddy boots and rusty tractors. And overcoming that sort of image problem is probably one of the biggest challenges that we have. Once we do that, it will be a completely different ballgame. There was consensus that engaging with grade 12 was probably too late, and we need to find a way of getting to the students at a much earlier age, probably even in primary school. There needs to be partnerships with industry, and we need to find a way of more proactively engaging with industry in order to get that image about the importance of an agricultural education across. There seems to be gaps in the degrees that we offer, and I have to be careful that I don't respond to these sorts of points. I find them very interesting, and I present them to you as they are. We will work through those and actually provide a response to that. Whilst I agree with that particular point, it does require a more nuanced response. Relationships underpin everything, and that will lead us to the rural communities of the futures, and that certainly resonates very much with me and comes back to some of the comments that I made in my opening address this morning. The second group in that section also discussed how we can identify niche opportunities for teaching, and they discussed things like having a 1 or 2 year degree or diploma that actually caters for farmers who want to increase their skill levels at a tertiary level. We need to raise the awareness of agriculture in households and schools. That was very much the same sort of point that the previous group raised as well. And then there was a question, does the degrees that we actually offer at UTAS really meet the demands for the industry? And these are very valid questions that are currently being taken up as part of our curriculum reform process. And finally, the group felt that we really need to promote the options that an agricultural degree offers when people have completed it, in terms of the versatility and the wide range of career paths that it actually opens. Thank you.